SCOTUS just made a big decision on Trump's border wall by rebuffing a challenge to the president's authority to make the wall happen, via the Washington Free Beacon. The U.S. Supreme Court on Monday rebuffed a challenge by three conservation groups to the authority of President Donald Trump's administration to build a wall along the U.S.-Mexico border, a victory for Trump, who has made the wall a centerpiece of his hardline immigration policies. The justices declined to hear the group's appeal of a ruling by a federal judge in California rejecting their claims that the administration had pursued border wall projects without complying with applicable environmental laws. The groups are the Center for Biological Diversity, the Animal Legal Defense Fund, and Defenders of Wildlife. Their lawsuits said construction operations would harm plants, rare wildlife habitats, threatened coastal birds like the snowy plover and California gnatcatcher, and other species such as fairy shrimp and the keynote checker spot butterfly. For once, common sense prevails. The security of the American people outweigh the needs of a butterfly. Besides, the president controls the border and immigration per the Constitution. In other immigration news, in an early morning tweet, President Trump threatened to permanently shut down the Mexico and the U.S. border unless Democrats agree to provide $5 billion in border wall funding. "We would save billions of dollars if the Democrats would give us the votes to build the wall. Either way, people will not be allowed into our country illegally. We will close the entire southern border if necessary. Also, stop the drugs. This is terrific, but it's terribly sad that Republicans didn't already get this done." The Daily Mail reports on Trump's threat to Democrats, and frankly to Mexico. President Donald Trump pressured Democrats to fund his wall or grapple with a shutdown of the border on Monday morning as he revived his immigration demands, despite a former president's passing. Trump had signaled over the weekend that he's willing to sign a two-week federal budget extension to allow Congress to honor the life of former President George H.W. Bush without the distraction of an impending partial government shutdown. As Bush's body was headed to Washington to lie in state in the U.S. Capitol, the sitting president whacked Democrats and put new pressure on legislators to give him the $5 billion he needs to complete the structure. "What former President Bush's funeral has to do with anything is beyond me. The nation's business should not be paused over a funeral. The crisis at the border is real and needs to be dealt with urgently. Not in 2 weeks. Action must be taken now. Please feel free to help support us by donating now or becoming a Patreon, as Facebook has greatly reduced the distribution of our stories in our readers' newsfeeds and is instead promoting mainstream media sources. When you share to your friends, however, you greatly help distribute our content. Please take a moment and consider sharing this article with your friends and family. Thank you."